Ava back over. Carolyn, how did you get from bringing the bell to there so quickly? Everyone could stand for lighting of the candles if you're able. Those of you who may be joining us via the internet, and if there are any announcements, if they would like to come up to the speaker inside.
Good morning. We had our trunk or treat event yesterday, and we had about 150 kids come. It was a huge success. So I just want to thank everyone who volunteered and who helped out. It was a lot of fun. And then my other announcement, if you're interested in teaching children's church, it's a lot of fun. The kids have a blast with it. It's really cool curriculum. I learn something new every week from it. So if you're interested in teaching children's church, let me know. Give me your email, or I can give you my email, and I can set you up with teaching. Thank you.
I just want to ask for some help. If anyone knows the whereabouts of the acolyte robes that used to hang in the upstairs altar guild room, I'd like to know. Thank you.
Oh, that's what they were.
Car waxers.
Good morning. My name is Al Mosier, and I'd like to just make a brief announcement about envelopes. This year, or next year, we're not ordering new envelopes, so when the year begins, I may come back to you with a new envelope number. But anybody who's interested in having envelopes in which to put their tithes and offerings, please let me know, because we've got lots of them, and we'll be happy to give them to you. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Glenda Abadi. I'm the chairman of the SPPRC. And October... I'm sorry, what? Is that on?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm the chair of the SPPRC. And in the United Methodist Church, the month of October is Pastor Appreciation Month.
Whoa!
Yeah. So, since we have a pastor, and we do appreciate him, especially for the fact that he is here 2 days after he's had surgery on his knee, I think that's outstanding. Don't stand up. We did a quick little stealth thing that you didn't know about. Nancy, of course, was involved, but we have some cards of appreciation for you, and we really do appreciate what you and your family have brought to us over the last year and a few months. It's a new journey for us, it's a new journey for you, and it's a fun ride so far.
Cindy? Morning. My name is Cindy Jones, and I'm here on behalf of the SOS Small Group, and we are presenting Pastor Niles with this pretty sign.
If you want.
Trustee here, and we are a group of people who managed to get a lot done, a lot with your help, but also a lot help with this man. He is one of our honorary trustees. He was here 6 months when a water pipe broke at some unholy hour of the morning. And he got his first initiation coming over here and dealing with this. He has been up in the attic with us, helping to fix the system up there. He has been in the bathrooms, helping to work on the bathrooms. I'm not sure they taught any of that in seminary school, but he has been a tremendous help to us, and we appreciate him. Thank you.
Good morning, I'm Adele Haskins. I apologize for my attire. I was at a grandchild's hockey game before church this morning. But I want to let you know about next Sunday. Next Sunday we are having chicken and biscuits from the chicken barbecue that we had the chicken left. We are throwing a chicken and biscuit bash after church. We are just asking for donations. Everything will be donated, so join us after church next Sunday for chicken and biscuits and some other goodies. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm humbled, and I simply say thanks to all of you for your love, your support, your encouragement. I do so on behalf of my wife, Lorna, and our son, Japheth, and Jeffrey as well, who is in the Virgin Islands, but very much a part of what we do here. Thank you so much, and we look forward to continuing the journey, and we trust that the Lord will take us from one level of success to another, that we will go from strength to strength. There are some things that you don't learn in seminary, you learn them in the congregation. So I've learned a lot from you already, and I look forward to learning even more. Immediately after worship today, everyone is invited to the fellowship hall. We have one of our firefighters here, Mr. Chris Kazza, who is going to lead us in a special presentation, fire safety, fire prevention. And let's give him our best support, please. So we look forward to his support. Then on Saturday, November the 3rd at 7 p.m., there's a free holiday concert by the U.S. Army 10th Mountain Division Band plus the Fulton Community Band. Some of you may know that I am a member of the Fulton Community Band. So we invite you to be a part of this concert. It's going to take place at the J. Ray Bodley High School Auditorium next Saturday, 7 p.m. At that auditorium. Looking forward to seeing some of you there. Thank you very much. And now our dear brother Chuck will lead us.
Okay, now we'd like to have the introit by the choir. Great gifts.
Thanks to God for all our blessings.
Our Heavenly Father, you are truly worthy to be praised. We need to praise you and thank you each and every day for the blessings and the mercies you give to us. You have created it all, and it's all yours. We are just the caretakers. Guide us to do this well. We ask that you guide Pastor and his leadership of us, and that his message is in your message, that we will do your will. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Now the Lord's Prayer.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The Lord's Prayer is from Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 through 13. But I don't think we read past that or go past that into verses 14 and 15. And one of the things that I challenge you maybe to do a little bit is to take those two verses and personalize them. And instead of it saying, for if you forgive others when they sin against you, your Heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. And instead of doing it or saying it or reading it that way, think of it as a personal note in that, for if I forgive other people's sins when they sin against me, then my Heavenly Father will forgive me. But if I don't forgive other people of their sins against me, then he will not forgive my sins either. So I challenge you all to keep that in mind as you read the Our Father or as you say the Our Father and go from there. Now we can all pass the peace.
Thank you.
children come up for the children's ministry?
He doesn't even need me anymore.
Now, there was a pressing question that's been bothering us all month. I don't know if anybody's come up with the final answer or not about whether is a pumpkin a fruit or a vegetable.
Oh, yes.
You know what the correct answer is? Yes. Here's the mic. Well, everybody was laughing, so they were either laughing at me or they heard me. It's always nice to have help. And the reason the answer is yes is because although it has seeds and it is edible, which is normally the classification and the way the botanists say for a fruit, it doesn't have the sweet flavor and stuff that a lot of fruits have. So the correct answer when somebody asks you, is a pumpkin a fruit or a vegetable? The answer is yes. Now, this month also, we've sang this song over and over again, and it's really a great song. And I guess the question is, as we sing, I've got the joy, joy, joy down in my heart. And if we look at the words, joy, another word for joy might be happiness. How do you guys feel happy? You guys, I like your smiles. You're always coming up and you smile, and we see you in the hallways and at other events around town, and you're always smiling. And I don't know whether you know it or not, but as the children, you bring a lot of joy to those of us who are adults.
Amen.
Sometimes we may be having a bad day or things aren't going right for us. And when we see one of you walking along and you put a big smile on your face, it normally puts a smile on our face. Also, the love of Jesus. And I think the more often that we think about the love of Jesus, that also brings a smile to our face. Because that's a pretty amazing thing when you stop and think about what Jesus has done for us. And the fact that as we read in the Bible, there are several parables where Jesus is showing his love by working miracles. And this is true today as he provides for all of us. And that Jesus asks that we believe in him and love him and love others. And as in John 13, he gives us a new commandment. And that is that we are to love one another as he has loved us. And that we should love one another. And how do we show love for other people? Yes? Give them a hug or a smile. That's a great way to start out, even if it's somebody you don't know. Any other ideas? Compliments? Compliments are always great. Sometimes just being nice, helping out, whether you talk about helping your parents or helping your teachers if you're in school or just helping people in general that might need help. And those are a lot of the ways that we can simply show love. And that we all show love in different ways. And we all receive love in different ways. Is it time to clean up? Are you bringing the paper towels because it's time to clean up? And as we show this love for everybody else, it brings the peace to us. And this is a way that Jesus also in his love brings us peace. And like I said earlier, I can tell you that all of you, and for those of you who were at the trunk or treat yesterday, you've seen some of us big kids having a lot of fun. And having a lot of fun, it was because you were smiling and you were laughing and you were having a good time. And some of us big kids joined right in. So one of the things that I would like you to do today as part of this and in showing the love to everybody else here in the parish is that we've got some things that we would, if I could have the snow princesses or the ice princesses come up here, please. Colleen's ready up here. Let's see who else we have out there might fall into this category. The two young men sitting over here. I seen one of you at ice skating last night. I don't know your name. Come on up. Come on up, please. We need some help up here. I hope you guys aren't offended that I'm considering you young people. So yesterday when we got done with the ice skating, we went home and we wanted to think of a way that as I was doing the children's service today and how much you guys shared your love with us all the time and your smiles and what you do, my wife and I decided that we would like to help you share the love with other people. So what I'd like to do is I'd like each one of you to come up here, and I've refrained from, there was discussions about wearing our costumes today. And I was, we had a kind of a mask yesterday that scared some people, so I thought that would probably not be a good thing to do today. But I had fun. But if each one of you would take a basket and walk around and either give a cookie with a heart or a sucker to all the people out there. And if you have any left in your basket, you might be able to have one too. Make sure you get one to everybody, all the way around the choir and everywhere else. Now that they are all far away, I will share with you.
She decided she
wants to. Smart math, come on. Thank you all. Enjoy the cookies, enjoy the sucker. When they get off.
Okay, I think we're through with that part, so thank you so much. And now you may go with Maddie to Children's Church. Thank you. Thank you, church. Very good. My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. Let us pray. We pray today for all who are sick, for those who care for the sick. O great physician, we pray for Fern Campbell, Sheila Sampson, Ali Falstick. We remember persons whose names are listed in our bulletin, and those who have not been mentioned but whom we know, who can use that special touch today, O great physician, that can make them whole, that can make them well. We pray that if it be your will, that they will experience physical healing. May all experience forgiveness of sins and spiritual healing. I give thanks today, O God, for the prayers of your people, for the procedure that I underwent on Friday. For those who attended to me, thank you, Lord, for your healing mercies, for the skill of the doctors and others who care for those who are sick or suffering from other conditions. We pray today for people who mourn, the families of the 11 that were killed in that mass shooting at the Pittsburgh synagogue, that their grief will be assuaged. We remember today Bonnie Cooper, in whose memory Brian and Sharon Gaia are sponsoring today's web ministry. Thank you for Bonnie's life. Grant rest, peace, and eternal joy to those who have died. We pray for those who serve in the church and wherever they may offer their skill, their service. We give thanks today in a very special way for our church secretary, Nancy Nixdorf, in whose honor Don Dyack is sponsoring today's web ministry. Thank you, Lord, for all who serve and help to advance the mission of the church. We pray for those who are trained to keep us safe, first responders, firefighters, police officers, rescue workers. We pray especially today for our brother Chris Kaza and his family, and all the members of the Fulton Fire Station. We thank you for the services they render. We pray for the presentation that Chris will make today, that it will be informative and helpful to all who attend. We pray, Lord, that you will protect and keep safe all those who are trained to keep others safe as they carry out their work. Lord, we pray for our country in the midst of domestic and other terrorism, hate crimes, anti-Semitism, violence, the charged political environment in which we find ourselves. We pray that peace and love will prevail, and that our leaders and all who are in positions of authority and influence will be examples of civility, and by their speech and actions will promote unity and goodwill. We give thanks, O gracious God, for this day, for this time, and we pray that you will continue to guide, inspire, and bless us as we worship. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Take me not
faithful servant. You have been faithful over a little. I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master. Well done. These are words of commendation. The man, the master, commends the two servants that made gains on what he had entrusted to them. Well done, he says, good and faithful servant. It is obvious from these words that the man was pleased with his servants. They had done well, and he offered them his well done. They used their initiative, made an effort, tried something, invested what they were given, and the results were amazing, great, well done. These are positive words, words of praise. The master wanted his servants to know that he appreciated what they had done. It was good for the servants to know that their master was pleased with their efforts. Well done. As we conclude this series on stewardship, I want to take this time, this opportunity, to express my appreciation to individuals who have been good and faithful stewards in this congregation. God has entrusted us with much. You have talent. I think of those who play the instruments and have been willing to invest their time in providing music for the congregation. I think of those who devote themselves, their time to singing. Those who understand technology and serve as our technicians. Those who have leadership and organizational and administrative skills and are willing to serve in our church office, on our board and committees, as directors and leaders of children, youth, women, and men's ministries. Those who take care of the facilities, doing maintenance, carrying out repairs and cleaning. Our worship leaders, our acolytes, ushers, and all who play a part in the mission and work of the congregation. I think of those of you who show up regularly, consistently. Well done. You provide a community of faith for persons who are viewing this service online, and your presence is a source of inspiration and upliftment to others. I say to you, well done. I appreciate all that you have done. Last night I was so touched at the celebration for the Fulton AA, when someone came and said to me on behalf of the congregation, "You're allowing us to use this building," he said, is saving lives. That's what he said. "You're helping to save lives." Well done, my sisters and brothers. Then, let us remember also The financial gifts with which we have been endowed. Money is a gift that's needed and can be used in the church. Like all of our other gifts, we are stewards of the money we possess and are called to invest it in God's service, in the mission. When John Wesley, you know that name, the founder of Methodism, visited congregations, he would question his assistants as to their progress in the faith. He would often ask if their Christianity had affected their pockets. That can be an acid test of our values. The hymn, "Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee," has a verse that goes, "Take my silver and my gold, not a mite would I withhold." Yes, brothers and sisters, I say, well done to those who have pledged and have given in support of the church's mission. Thank you for your regular tithes and offerings, your special contributions. We have printed in the bulletin today the wonderful response to hurricane relief, to disaster relief that this congregation has made. Thank you so much for what you have done and the ways you have supported the mission with your finances. Well done. Yes, brothers and sisters, as we read the parable, we discover that there was one servant who, instead of hearing that word of commendation, well done, heard a word of condemnation. You lazy and worthless servant. And this is a reminder that not every servant does well and makes the kind of effort that is worthy of praise. Some give in to laziness or complacency and do not live up to their worth or what is expected of them. The master says, well done to the servants who did their best with what they had been given. And I say well done to you who are doing the best with what God has entrusted to you to help the mission, the growth of the church, and the advancement of the gospel. With those words of commendation come an offer of promotion. If you look at the text for today, you will hear the master saying to his servants, "You have been faithful over a little. I will place you over much." After commending his servants for their wonderful, outstanding efforts, the master rewards them with a promotion. They are given more responsibility. You know, my friends, it is said that the reward for work well done is not less work, but more work. They have proven themselves. He expressed his appreciation for what they did, then asked them to do more. He didn't say, well, it's time that you stop working. The man increased their responsibilities. He offered them, he assigned them to larger duties. And this is something that we must see and appreciate. Having expressed appreciation and praise for what you have done, members of this congregation, for your faithful stewardship and service. I call on you now to do more. Maybe more of the same. Maybe more in terms of trying something different, something that you probably never tried before. We are calling on you to give more of your time, more of your talent, more of your thoughts, your ideas, more of your money to the mission and growth of the church so that we can continue our local ministries and assist with other ministries, increasing our influence and strengthening our witness in this community and beyond. In the letter to the Galatians, chapter 6, verse 9, we read, "Let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up." It's unfortunate, friends, that sometimes individuals do well up to a point, then seem not to be able to continue to keep the momentum going. As God's servants, we are not called to rest on our laurels, to sit on our hands and speak of yesterday's successes and achievements as though they are today's. Each day is a new opportunity for greater service and continued stewardship. We are called to grow, to advance, to progress. And finally, my friends, with those words of commendation, we find an invitation. Enter into the joy of your master. The New Living Translation of the Bible says, "Come, let's celebrate together." The master invites the two servants he commends to enter into joy, to celebrate. Brothers and sisters, joy is another reward for faithful service and stewardship. And who doesn't want joy? We all want joy. And we can find joy in the service of the Lord. We can find joy as stewards of God's manifold blessings. This invitation to enter joy comes not just at the end of service, but even while the servants are assigned more and greater responsibility. You see, oftentimes we think of this joy as something that will come at the end of life. When we die, we will enjoy the sweet by and by. But this is a joy that we can experience in the here and now, and not just in the hereafter. I read somewhere that a parishioner's parting words to his pastor were penetrating and pertinent. He simply said, "Whatever you do, don't miss the joy." Whatever you do, whatever you do now, whatever you do in the church, don't miss the joy. And there's a Robert Louis Stevenson at the end of his life who said, "To miss the joy is to miss everything." There is joy, my friends, in serving God. Brothers and sisters, when we do well, the Lord is pleased and says, "Well done." When we do well, it pleases the Lord to give us more responsibility. Because we have done so well, so the Lord gives us more to do, makes us responsible for more. We step up when we do well. while doing well, we are invited to share in the joy of the Lord. So let us give thanks that even now as we serve, the joy of the Lord is our strength, and the joy, that joy will increase as others are blessed through our service, through our witness, through our stewardship, through the sacrifices that we make, the sharing of the gospel in which we are involved, and all that we do to improve our community and our world. Others will be blessed by what we do. And that, my friends, is a tremendous source of joy. So let us go forth then to continue to do the best we can, to rise to the occasion, to accept the other responsibilities that God is entrusting us to accept. And let us experience that joy, a joy and a peace that the world cannot give and cannot take from us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now receive the benediction, my sisters and brothers. May God bless you as you give yourself to the Lord so that he can use you mightily in his service. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, guide, protect, and bless you. The Lord mercifully watch over you and be gracious unto you and pour out upon you the abundance of his goodness, that you may live in peace and in the world to come have eternal rest and peace and joy and life. Amen.